What is up, my T-spiracy people? We are going to go over some lingering things from the live that I had.
I am going to read some of the comments, and I am going to respond.
Before I get started, just know that some of you might not like my response, and that's okay. I will sleep fine at night knowing that I said what I mean, and I mean what I say, and everything comes from a place of good intentions, and everybody's viewpoint is different. When I started this channel, I said to myself, please do not play a character. That is one thing I do not like. I do not like people who come on YouTube, play a character, things unravel. We watch them, you know, unpeel their layers until we actually see who they are. And then we go, oh, you're fake, you know, and I don't like that. So I've always said since day one, I'm going to be who I am. And love it or hate it, at least I am who I am. Green eggs and ham. I am Sam.
Just kidding. I'm not Sam. I'm AZ. And when I feel how I feel, I give zero.
And when I say that I'm not directing at any specific person, I don't have any problems with any creators. I'm just saying what I'm saying. And I'm no longer playing. And I'm gonna, I don't know, man, I keep rhyming today. Anyways, if people take offense to what I say, that's on them. I can't take responsibility for how my choice of words makes somebody feel unless I am being careless with my words in reckless, then yes, maybe I would. But I cannot, nobody should live their lives scared to say things for fear that it would make somebody else uncomfortable.
But AZ, check your DM. There's a troll on me on Twitter talking crap about you. PSA, I don't care. One, I'm not there to defend myself, so there's that. And for two, if you think that I'm gonna let a woman who dredged up somebody's SA report tell me that my moral compass is off, child, you got another thing coming. That'll be a cold, cold day. All I'm doing is looking at all angles that could possibly exist in a case that we have all been obsessing over for quite some time. You can drag my name through the mud all you like, because the people that love me, like me, respect me, all know that my intentions are pure and that it comes from a place of simply just asking questions. Nothing more, nothing less. So stop burning your brain cells trying to make it something it ain't. Anywho, let's get into the first comment.
So, Naomi says, this is the worst stream I've heard. All of you hating on a mentally vulnerable woman, you all sound like bullies in a playground. You want to count yourselves lucky? Because if this was me, I would have reported you all by now for harassment and slander. How about we give Nat a chance to explain herself? I have questions too, but the thought of ripping pieces out of a woman who's known to have severe mental health issues is disgusting. Not only that, but by doing so, you are questioning a top attorney. I'm in actual disbelief.
Hating on a mentally vulnerable woman. Girl, where? Please, I need timestamps because that never took place.
I don't even know where somebody would be confused that maybe that was even said. There's nothing here that even could be misconstrued as hating on a mentally vulnerable woman. No, no. I mean, here's the thing, guys. If we stop questioning people because they have, you know, some kind of mental problem, then where do you draw the line with that? Who's the ultimate judge of like, oh, well, you can ask people with this mental disorder questions, but not kind of this one. Like, hello, most of us have some sort of mental condition. I myself included, you know, like that doesn't work anywhere. I mean, even in court, like, let's just say, you know, you hurt somebody and stand before the judge and you say, oh, my mental illness, you know, whatever. Like, you think the judge is going to be like, oh, all right, bro, like, it's all good. Don't worry about it. Like, have a good day. Furthermore, it drives me absolutely insane, and I know that people believe in this, and hey, you know, to each their own, but for somebody to say, oh, how dare Charlotte question somebody who has, you know, mental problems, like, that could lead to bad stuff, like, okay, well, say Charlotte holds all that in, right? And maybe let's say Charlotte has a mental problem, because none of us really know. Do you know what I mean? And she holds all that in and it eats at her. And then she has an even bigger problem because she kept quiet. You know what I'm saying? Like, where is the line in the sand here for what's acceptable and what's not? Personally, I would never remain quiet to appease somebody else. I just wouldn't, especially if it was affecting me.
Oh, and let's not forget ripping pieces out of a
woman who has mental health issues. What? Were we watching the same stream? Are you lost, ma'am? Ma'am, are you lost? Because I don't think you were watching my stream. I don't. I really think you're lost. I mean, I have GPS. I have a map. Let me know if I can give you some direction, you know? I don't know, man. Someone virtue thou signal in the wrong direction, I guess. And this is what I'm talking about. This person will take that comment, go to Twitter, go here, go there, give this impression that that's what took place on my stream when we all know that that's not true, okay? It's not. So stop playing, Naomi. I do believe the people who are critical of Charlotte's stream feel that it's wrong to question the credibility of a severely mentally ill person. It's a line you don't cross. When you question inconsistencies in the declaration, you are basically questioning her credibility. And then people start to speculate about her health, which is a no-no for many. A lot of people think you have no right to speculate about another person's health from a distance, that it's ignorant and unethical. In this case, Nat has been open with thoughts of suicide. People take that serious.
Okay, I appreciate your constructive feedback comment. You know who you are. I'm not going to use your name, but I appreciate you when you put it to us like that. However, I feel like people who are... This is just my opinion, man. I know everyone's not going to agree with me, right? So you're saying, like, it's a line you don't cross, right? Or they're saying that. It's a line you don't cross. But I'm going to tell you why sometimes it is okay to cross that line, okay? And, you know, if I get thrown to the gallows for my, you know, way I feel about it, then so be it. I mean, in my heart, I believe that this is the best way to go about it. It's what I was taught. It's what I believe in. First, I want to say self-harm should always be taken seriously. Secondly, I want to say it's okay to draw boundaries with people. And sometimes people use it as a manipulation tactic. And, you know, sometimes people use it to try to get what they want. I mean, it's just the sad facts of life, you guys. I feel like some people are scared to say that. Now, in this case, we have somebody who has been very open about her diagnosis. I don't think that all of them were mentioned in the declaration. I know that she said that Instagram was hers, said there was a video made about it. She said, yes, that was my Instagram. I did educate myself on DID. I mean, I was kind of familiar with DID. I had never, you know, at the mental institution, I had never worked with anybody with it, but I knew about it. And this is a problem for me. So when people say it is never okay to question the credibility of a severely mentally ill person, I have a problem with that. In my eyes, it is okay to question that person. It's okay to question any person. I know that we live in a time and era where, you know, it has like the Me Too movement and things like that. And we've been lately, as of late, especially been conditioned to believe that you always believe the victim. Okay. And I understand that. And if somebody came to me and said, hey, this something horrible happened, like I would be the first one to probably be there for them. Okay. I'm not discounting what people go through. I'm not. Token on the other side of that coin, I am not going to bend my boundaries, my health, my own health limits, my own mental health to appease that person to keep them stable. Nobody should do that, okay? Because sometimes, and I'm not saying in this circumstance, I'm saying sometimes people can use emotional blackmail manipulation techniques of self-harm to get what they want. And I've seen it happen, especially working with those teenage girls. If you don't let me call my boyfriend, I'm gonna go and do this, okay? And I was always taught to acknowledge it. At first, obviously get help if someone threatens self-harm. I think that should go without saying, but you know, you acknowledge it and you definitely still draw a boundary. You say, hey, look, I hope you don't do that. I would prefer you do not do that. But if you do choose to do that, I cannot be held responsible for that, you know? And the same goes with like speaking. Oh, and I feel like a lot of the people saying that you should never question these people think that by questioning them, you're discounting their, you know, their problems and their the things they suffer with and, you know, their past. And it's not about it, that just because you question somebody with a mental, you know, illness doesn't mean that you're discounting them. It doesn't mean that, you know, they're lying. It means that it's just as simple as that. You're questioning it just like you would question it if the person wasn't. I mean, we don't give free passes on consequences to people
who have mental illnesses. Well, in severe cases, we do. I mean, some people, instead of going to jail, they will go and get, you know, mental help or whatever. But
in the grand scheme of things, as big as mental health really is, I mean, how often does that even happen, considering how grand this scale is?
You have, from a legal perspective, and listen, I am not a legal person. I don't know nothing about nothing, okay?
I would like to know more about this topic, actually. I would be open to conversation with somebody like Uncivil Law, wink wink, my boyfriend, but I'm pretty sure he's terrified of me.
So it is okay, man, and I don't know why everybody is so scared to be like, hey, you know, I know it sucks questioning this person, but it is okay to question everybody, and I feel like people are just so scared to say that, and people love to virtue signal at the same time. I mean, people who virtue signal love it. They love it.
And something I've noticed is if the virtue signal aligns with a favorable outcome, thy virtue signal gets stronger. And people are scared to say that, man. They are. Everybody has a fear, especially people on public platforms who are trying to build a following, have a fear of being canceled. I mean, we've seen it unfold before our eyes with people like BX Beast Boy, you know, etc. People have this fear of being canceled. There is a fine line between, you know, getting canceled and seeing things for what they are, you know? And that's really all I have to say about it. I mean, you know, I'm not trying to tear apart this person like the person said in their comment. I would never try to do that. Are you kidding me? I struggle with mental health. I've worked in the mental health field. I've worked at a mental institution. Like, I know that this stuff is no joke, okay? Even our court of law, from what I understand, from what I've read, you know, is trying to make it so, you know, we normalize people with mental health disorders, as we should. We now let them testify to certain things, whereas years ago we didn't. So if we're letting people with mental disorders testify, right, and they can be cross-examined and all this, so what is the difference? I mean, aren't we trying to treat them like they're everyday people? That is the ultimate goal, or so I thought. But if the ultimate goal is to treat these people with mental health, all of them, well, even myself, as normal, you know, everyday citizens, telling them that, oh, no one should be questioning you, it makes them, it, in my opinion, it leads them to believe they are different. It, you know, it puts them in a category, and then we're right back to where we were years ago when they're not even allowed to testify, and we're trying to change that, or so I thought. In fact, after seeing some of your comments and, you know, really taking a good look at this, I decided to do some research on it, because that's what I do. You know, I did the research on the DID, dissociative identity disorder, right? It has not changed the way I feel. It has not changed the fact that I think this person should be questioned. But DID is very interesting nonetheless. And I will link a few videos in my description for you guys if you have any interest in dissociative identity disorder.
I think social media platforms have a way of overcomplicating things sometimes. And I think that people are thoroughly overthinking this into oblivion. Like, I mean, it's simple. It's just questioning somebody who may possibly have a motive, who may possibly not have a motive. It's as simple as that. It's not an attack on, you know, someone's perceived pain or what they go through or the trauma they've experienced or anything like that. I mean, just everybody needs to stop putting words in other people's mouths and assuming things and thinking they know intentions, because you don't. You don't. And that's that. And like I said, I am open to conversation to learn more on this matter. As far as a legal standpoint goes, I know that nobody's going to want to talk about, you know, the person in question, and that's fine. I don't want to either, but I would like to know more about mental illnesses and how it works in the legal system. It's something that obviously needs to be talked about. A lot of people are very ignorant to it, and you know, I'm always up to learn something new if in case I do need to learn something new, whatever. If you or someone you know is struggling with mental health, there is help available, okay? There is. You are not alone, and you really should talk to somebody. It really helps, all right? Okay, my Teaspiracy people, thank you for listening. Thanks for hearing me out. Thanks for not believing what other people tell you my intentions are, because that's just weird. All right, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.